Hey, Shemp, prep the interrogation room. I'm bringing a kid in relation to the Amber Breen case. Looks like murder.
Tomorrow's the big day, James. You're our star witness. All of the other evidence rests on the foundation of your testimony. You've been prepped for this. All you have to do is tell the truth, and this will all be over.
That's right, kid. Don't worry. With your help, we'll make sure she goes away for a long time. Oh, sweet. Did you remember to get the almond milk coffee creamer?
I'm almost out.
Now look here. Justice isn't something to be scared of or try to avoid. It will be good for everyone involved, even Sarah. She's fallen down a bad road, but doing some time might be enough to turn her around.
I don't know.
James, justice, real justice, is always a good thing.
That's right, Captain. Nothing as sweet as justice.
The prosecution calls James Hawthorne to the witness stand.
Use your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Yeah. Yes, I do.
Mr. Hawthorne, where were you on the night of November 22nd?
I was at this bridge.
And why were you at this bridge?
Amber. She called me. She needed help.
You received a phone call that night?
She needed me. This is all my fault. It's my fault just as much as Sarah's. Do you hear me? It's my fault she's dead.
Thank you, Mr. Hawthorne. There are no further questions at this time, Your Honor. The prosecution rests.
Your Honor, the prosecution's witness is clearly emotionally distraught. The prosecution has failed to bring credible witness against my client. Your Honor, the defense moves for dismissal.
Sustained. Case dismissed. Detective Cross, Hamilton Police Department. How can I help you? Did you say 32001 Cascade Boulevard? Okay, thank you. Detective Lawson, sir. Someone just called in anonymously and mentioned that girl Sarah's apartment. I think we should check it out.
Hamilton PD, Detective Lawson. Hamilton PD, Detective Lawson.
Too clean if cleanliness is next to godliness.
All good, Lawson.
Oh, come on, cheer up, boss. I'm sure James is happy knowing that, you know, she's not gonna get too far away from the law.
Yeah, well, maybe if we didn't have this peanut gallery, we'd be able to clean this mess up. Shem, I want you to go over to James's residence, see if he's home. I don't want him hearing about this from the 10 o'clock news.
This late? All right, well, if nothing happens, yeah, I'll see you tomorrow morning. Remember to save me a few donuts.
You don't really think James had anything to do with this, do you?
No, but he seemed tormented from his experience earlier. As much as I hate to say it, I think we're in the same boat. This is gonna be a long week.
Hey, careful. She's got it out for you.
Who is she? I don't have any scheduled appointments today.
Fed from up north. Somehow they caught wind of last night's murder. She's claiming jurisdiction now.
Alright, thanks.
Like I said, it's been a single day we have control of the situation. Well, Lawson, thank goodness you're here, man.
Thanks, Shem. I can take it from here. I got a stack of TPS reports for you to do anyway.
Understood. Thanks.
Apologies about Shem. You can get a bit passionate sometimes. My name's Detective Lawson, and you are?
Higgins, Special Agent Sandra Higgins. Tell me, Detective, how did you manage to lose and open a shut case like that?
Something tells me you're about to tell me.
I'd say you got too friendly with the witness and skewed his thought process pre-trial. Your pal Shemp told me how your posse may have riled him up.
Shemp.
Oh, hey, Cross.
Search of the surrounding area of Sarah Fisher's apartment. We managed to find James Hawthorne's car parked several blocks away.
Ludicrous. My people did a thorough search of the surrounding area and came up with nothing.
Exactly my point. You become too close to the case and you've gotten sloppy. Maybe you've become too lax with your team as well. Not so fast, Detective. Your squad has made a mockery of this case. Until further notice, I'm placing your squad as support team. Until this dark cloud passes over. We've got it from here. My men have surrounded the county. Don't you worry. James isn't getting very far.
Hey, Detective. Something about Shemp today seemed off. I followed him back to the remote cabin village on the south side. I saw his car parked up front, but he was nowhere in sight. There's something strange going on here. I'm gonna go investigate, but I just wanted to keep you in the loop, boss. Cross out. Shemp, I think you left your phone at the precinct. I was just... Shemp, is that you?
Kyle, I've come back. Are you okay? I'm sorry, James. I can't do this right now.
Babe, you were doing fine.
Let me guess as always. Look, James. We just had our 5th anniversary. Don't you think it's time we start taking things a little more serious?
Please, Amber, we can't have this discussion right now. Your play's next week.
Well, if not now, then when, James? I'm just tired of seeing all my friends off and happy. I guess I just feel left behind.
Amber, what's the rush? We're still feeling things out. We're not even stable. We have a whole life ahead of us.
Well, maybe I want to make those mistakes while I still can. You know what? Whatever. Let's just go from the top and finish rehearsal. To meet with Sarah later and discuss some things.
Sarah?
Ah! is it? James?
Sarah? Sarah! No!
I followed him back to the remote cabin village on the south side. His cruiser's parked out front, but he's nowhere in sight. There's something strange going on here. I'm gonna investigate, but I wanted to keep you in the loop, boss. Cross, out.
Special Agent, you're gonna have to trust me on this. Something's coming up and I need to move now.
What are you talking about, Detective? I thought I grounded your unit. What's going on here?
I'm not hearing anything from Detective Cross. She went out to check a cabin on the south side and I can't get a hold of her. I think she's in danger and James might be involved.
James. All right, Detective, you've got my attention, but it's not going to be wasted on wild goose chases. You think I'm gonna let you off that easy?
Fine. You can take my badge. I don't care if you let me go or not, but I'm not abandoning my people.
Very well, Detective. You can go. But I'm coming with you. James is mine.
There. That's Cross's.
Let's move, Detective.
Cross! Cross.
Officer down! I repeat, officer down! Send backup to my location. What's this? Looks like your star witness is about to go off the deep end.
No. I've seen this before. This could be a forgery. James might be in trouble.
Whatever the case may be, we've got to get over to that bridge.
Tries to come back out your way. Shemp, do you copy? Over.
Lawson, Shemp, do you read me? Over. I have a positive ID on James Hawthorne.
Hey!
Thank you.
right here. Don't let anyone get past this point. First person you see, blow your whistle. Something's not right here.
I'll hold it here. Be careful when they're detected. Him.
Please don't shoot. I'm innocent. I'm running for my life.
On your knees, identify yourself.
Please, you don't understand. I'm not. His tree's coming after me.
I said don't move. On your knees now.
My name is James Hawthorne. I'm innocent. I'm not the killer.
James?
Drop it, Shemp. I'm gonna give you to the count of three.
I'm sorry, boss, I can't. I have no choice. It's
one.
Him or me. But boss, he framed himself.
Two.
I have to do this.
Three. Sense in falling any further, right, kid?
Peace like a river ran through the city. Long past the midnight curfew, we sat starry-eyed. Oh, oh, we were satisfied. Oh, and I remember misinformation followers like a plague. Nobody knew from time to time if the plans were changed. Oh, 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 if the plans were changed. You can beat us with wires, you can beat us with chains, you can run out your rules, but you know you can't outrun a history train. I seen a glorious day. I